So the Dominican Republic was the most profound experience of my life, and it's something that I reference in my mind when I'm thinking about where I want to go and what will matter to me most as I continue on in our journey.
Overcoming that language barrier has helped me make connections with people that I didn't think I could ever make, and this level of empathy that I have is insane now. The second thing that is the biggest impact on my everyday life is I kind of had this epiphany when I was there as to what I wanted to do with my life and if service career was something maybe I wanted to do, and traveling internationally. And
while we were high up in the mountains of Huayac Alto, staying with host families in Peru, sitting on three-legged camping chairs in a tiny room where you couldn't even stand up straight, we were able to reflect on our place in the world and what it means to be human and striving to serve others. Without Felice's advocacy and vision, I truly believe that many students from my high school would not have the opportunity or courage to see themselves in community with our global neighbors.
So excited about the impact and the difference they're going to make in this world because of this experience, so thank you again.
I started off this year with a service project in the Dominican Republic. When I arrived to the Batays, I was just thinking about the impact that we would have on their lives, but I was not at all prepared for the impact they would have on mine. They taught me about what it truly means to be happy and how little it takes to like have a good and meaningful life. It was more than just a service experience, it was more like a journey of self-discovery, and I cannot wait for the impact that the indigenous people of Peru will have on my life when I travel there this February.
Definitely, the two trips that I got to go on gave me a perspective about the world and just people that I would not have gotten if I had just stayed in Bloomfield the whole time. It's also worth mentioning that Prindle is the reason I got a scholarship to go to college, so very grateful for that. And yeah, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Going to Cuba was just a crazy idea at first, but Mrs. Prindle made it a reality. In Cuba, we planted mangroves as a line of defense against hurricanes and other natural disasters. I also witnessed the crippling effects that limited access to education, healthcare, and other basic resources have on many families. While I began to start to understand these situations by standing in solidarity with the Cubans, I began to recognize the magnitude of social justice issues as well. I realized that this was just the beginning and that we all had the potential to be change makers. This project pursued me to embark on another service project to the Dominican Republic my senior year, and to enter college at John Carroll University as an Arupe scholar, dedicating myself to furthering my knowledge about prominent social justice issues and the root causes of many systemic injustices that permeate our world. None of this would have been possible without Felice Prindle. These service projects have served as a catalyst for education, reflection, growth, and empowerment. They have allowed me to be an ambassador for change far away and close to home. She has allowed me to recognize my passion and purpose in this world, and to her, no amount of thank yous are enough.
It all started as an idea to travel internationally with my students and engage in a culturally immersive service project. I'll never forget how nervous we were, our group of 18 trailblazers, presenting a project for Board of Education approval. Cuba, who's been to Cuba? Asked our superintendent. And we would, in fact, be some of the first Americans in over 50 years to do just that. It was doubtful that our board would approve such a novel proposal. We are a small school, graduating about 70 per class, located in conservative rural upstate New York. Many of my students have not traveled on an airplane. Most of my students have not traveled internationally, but they did say yes, and so our journey to Cuba began. That first year was extremely hard. Fundraising out of the backseat of my car, planning a trip to a virtually unknown destination, and confronting the controversy that came with a trip to Cuba. But when we reached the top of the nature preserve in Lomas de Bonao, it was all worth it. 5 years later, 3 countries, 6 trips, over 100 students transformed through immersive, authentic impact travel. And it all started as an idea. Travel is transformative. It gives us others' eyes and builds bridges. When we travel, we replace the dots on the map with smiling faces. Travel is essential, but impact travel gifts us even more. Impact travel is evocative. It makes us feel and awakens us. It illuminates our path with purpose and relevance. And this is why I dedicate most of my professional life as a school counselor curating projects of international service. Whether planting mangrove seeds along Cuba's Zaza River or building latrines in the Batays of the Dominican Republic, or constructing an elementary school in Peru's Sacred Valley, my students return from our experiences forever changed, open-minded, self-aware, and with a unique perspective of shared humanity. Their hearts are activated with loving compassion. I am especially honored to receive this award because I have roots in travel and tourism. Professionally, I began with a bachelor's in hospitality, and my transition to education was unexpected and unusual. This is why these service travel projects are so meaningful and urgent. I would like to thank the Student and Youth Travel Association and its members for this award. Thank you for celebrating the spirit of youth travel. I also want to challenge our travel and tourism partners to remember we are an industry defined by service. We must work diligently to create more spaces for authentic, sustainable impact travel that incorporate service projects, engaging and empowering local communities so that we no longer narrate other stories, but instead we listen. Thank you to my students for joining me and one another on our journeys. Thank you for trusting me to take you far from home so you could see your own backyard more clearly. Thank you for your willingness to accept the gift of travel and service, and for understanding that with this gift comes great responsibility. To live a life of substance through your continued service, and to invite and inspire those around you to do the same. And finally, let me express my unconfined gratitude to the communities that we serve. To the people of Cuba, thank you for welcoming us and for forgiving decades of misunderstanding. To the Quechua village of Huilac Alto, Peru, thank you for giving us a place to forever call home. And to the beautiful people of the Batays, thank you for inspiring us to live a life full of dignity and with love. And to our soon-to-be host families in Perca Norte along Lake Titicaca, thank you for your patience. We're coming, I promise. And in closing, let me leave you with this. The world needs more travelers. It needs empathetic souls who unite through connections and the human condition. Let's transform the next chapter of youth travel together, celebrating the beauty and complexity of the world through travel experiences. And let's start with our youth. Thank you.